Good morning, Victory Life, and all you wonderful people tuning in to time in the Word of God. It's time well spent. And we want to, again, cover one of the most important aspects of the Word of God. What Jesus thinks is important, I believe you should say, is important in my life too. I mean, it was he who brought us this new life of the wonderful covenant that we have with him. And he shows us, patterns us. In fact, three times in the fourth chapter of Mark, he refers to a special principle and how this kingdom works. What is the kingdom of God? We're going to talk about the kingdom of God and sowing seed here today because it is the foundation. In fact, Jesus says, if you don't get this parable, you ain't going to get any of the other ones either. And so this is the huge, this is the beginning. This is the first steps to a successful, triumphant, glorious, victorious life in Jesus. This is not optional for some people that find, well, it's the ones that find it that actually get to enjoy the principles of it and start seeing things manifesting in their life. So it's not optional. This is for everybody. And so we want to start out in the fourth chapter. We're going to take it right to verse 26. And this is the second time that he mentions seed. And he says, and he said to the kingdom of God is like a man that scatters seed on the ground. And so the third time is in verse 30. And he said to them, with what can I compare the kingdom of God, or what parable shall I use to illustrate and explain it? It is like a grain of mustard seed. So the first one was, which is the whole chapter 4, of the sower sows the word. And there's four different kinds of soil. Then there's the other two occasions where he's talking about seed. The kingdom of heaven, I'll read it again. The kingdom, he said, the kingdom of God is like a man who scatters seed on the ground. So therein lies the information that, in fact, let me read you this here. Kingdom of God is the spiritual realm over which God reigns as king, or fulfillment thereof, God's principles here on the earth. And so that's where God reigns. Now, he wants to reign in every heart. And so if reigning in your heart means that you understand that there is a process, seed, time, and harvest that happens in every man, woman, boy, and girl's, mom and dad, grandpa, grandma's heart. There's seed, time, and harvest. And so we got to get to understand this wonderful principle. The kingdom of heaven is like a man that sows seed into the ground. And how many know that a farmer knows what he's doing when he's sowing seed into the ground? He doesn't stand there and say, are you kidding me? I sold seed last year. Are you kidding me? I got to go to the feed store and get more feed or seed. You know, why do I need to do this same principle again? Didn't I do this last year? No, the farmer knows exactly what quantity of seed to get, how much seed to sow, what he needs to do with the soil in order to grow. And again, we're not into agriculture here today, not in this lesson, but again, Jesus, being where he was at the time he was, had to make a choice of which kind of a parable he would use so that people would understand a realm that's inside their heart and how it functions. And so Jesus looked around and he said, see that farm over there? A man, it's like a man sowing seed into the ground. That's how the kingdom of heaven is going to be. And so for you and me, it will now behoove us to make sure that we are the man that is scattering seed on the ground, or the seed we know is the Word of God, that it needs to get distributed into good soil. So we're going to spend a lot of time here, and we want to make sure that we understand this principle. So in Luke chapter 17, verse 21, it says, the kingdom of God is within you. Write it down, Luke 17, 21. The kingdom of God. I know there's a kingdom coming. You know, Jesus is coming back and setting up the millennial reign. But right now, inside of every believer, is the kingdom of God. The ones that are successful are those that understand what I'm going to be sharing. The ones that are just passing through this life are the ones that are not understanding the concept of sowing the seed, seed time and harvest. What is the seed? What is the time duration? What is sowing? How do I sow? Where do I sow? What am I doing to see the kingdom of God advance in my life? And it's not just your life, but it is everything that you have your hands into. It is based on, if you are a believer, and I'm going to read you this scripture, you all know it, Matthew 6, verse 33. It says, but seek first the kingdom of God. So that is telling me I need to consider the lesson that we have today. I need to understand it from the Word of God, that there is a seed being sown. No seed, no harvest. It's just that simple. And so the verse in Matthew 6, 33, but seek first the kingdom of God and his way of doing things. Okay, it's not just, okay, I'm going to go to church. And here, we all know in James chapter 1, we covered that to go into the just hearing the Word of God and walking away is going to be absolutely, bring no fruition into your life. But going to the things of God, we are supposed to be productive. And so what Jesus is saying, Matthew 6, 33, there's another scripture, Matthew 5, where he says, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. So the concept of everything, and you know, in Matthew chapter 5, people were moaning and crying and having a hard time. But he says, be patient. The kingdom is at hand. And if you're mourning, you're going to be blessed. Blessed are those that mourn. Why? Because without the kingdom, whether you are a New Testament believer or an Old Testament believer, not activating these principles, you're going to be doing a lot of mourning and moaning and groaning and wondering what's going on. Well, you'll still pass through life. Everybody does. We all exist. But it's not about existing. It's about taking the kingdom and principles and working them allowing them to grow in your heart so that you would be productive, some 30, some 60, some 100-fold. And in every realm, God's plans and purposes for your life, in every area that he has for you. So Matthew 6, verse 33 again, but seek first the kingdom of God, his way of doing things, his way of acting, using his ingredients of what he said, how he said it. You know, there's a lot of, when you think of the Trinity, and let's say we could get poured it up to heaven right now, and they were sitting back and saying, man, we gave them all the 66 books. And again, people claim there's more, but a lot of those books that were also written didn't fit into and had different stuff in them. And so I trust the Holy Spirit that he has given us, like the 66 fold of curtains in the old in the temple in the Old Testament, he's given us what we need. This is our seed bag, our promise bag. This is where we get God's mind, God's will, God's purpose, everything we draw, extract it out of there. And then there's that principle that we're still working on, bringing you. Still back to Matthew 6, 33. Seek first the kingdom of God and his way of doing things. And all the other things, everything, when you do that, the things that the world is running crazy about, going day and night, you know, three jobs and everything that, again, we're not against work, but everything in balance, everything the way according to the kingdom of God. So many people are running to and fro, and at the end of their life, they've missed everything that God had for them. And it just, there's a way that seemeth right unto the man, but at the end there's destruction. And so those that do not seek the kingdom of God first, but the other things, are going to be disappointed in life. And that could be your fancy car, your fancy house, your all the different things. I know from statistics that the greatest group of people that commit suicide are those that sought after the things that, according to Matthew 6:33, will be added unto those that are seeking first the principles of God, God's way of doing it. The greatest group of people, because there's nothing outside of seeking the kingdom of God or being in right standing with God. There's nothing as important as that to understand it, to live by it. And so then it goes on. It says in Romans 14, verse 17, the kingdom of God is not meat nor drink, but righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Spirit. So again, he's laying the perimeter. We haven't even started how to do it, but what we're doing is showing you. I'm showing you the perimeter of what he says. Here it works. Here's the kingdom. There's principles involved. Outside of that, you're going to be living a miserable life. And it's something that we got to consider. And so he told us that the kingdom of God is not meat or drink, or things that you think here on this planet are important, but righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Spirit. Again, that is going back to in the sixth chapter of Matthew. Seek first the kingdom of God. Seek first the kingdom. Say that with me. Seek first the kingdom of God. You say, what is it? We haven't started yet, but I'm getting to the fact that it must be first in line with what you're doing. Okay. Mark verse 1:15 says, the time is fulfilled and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe the gospel. Believe the good news. God came with good news. God came with the gospel. And taking that principle, it says in verse 26 again, and he said, the kingdom of God is, so like a man that scatters seed onto the ground, then continues sleeping and rising night and day. We haven't discussed what kind of seed yet. Well, let's put it simple here. It's the scripture I just read out of Mark chapter 1, verse 15 says, believe the gospel, the good news. So for us as believers, the good news, number one, that Jesus came to set us free, to redeem us, to buy us back, that we can have a relationship with him, that we can get rid of sin in our lives, that we get to be born again, all because of his grace and mercy on our life. I mean, that is a cornerstone. Jesus, the Christ, is a cornerstone of the gospel. Now that is the good news. Taking something that, and that's me, you know, we were like filthy rag was our righteousness. We were stooped in sin. We were a fallen race of people, and he made us a new creature, as it says, one that never existed before. So not just a mere new creature, but a creature of a type, the God type of man, the type that he designed from the beginning. Let us breathe into man. And man became a living soul. And then, of course, we know the fall happened, but now we get to be reborn again into newness of life. So that's the good gospel news, that we get to have forgiveness of sin. Hallelujah. That's why we get to forgive people. Forgiveness of sin is so important, because that's the first thing that the Father did for us. He forgave us all of our iniquities, and he heals all of our diseases. And so that is the nutshell, very quick nutshell, of the kingdom of God that came into us. And so what is this business in verse 27 that says, because he says the kingdom of God, the realm where God lives, remember, and the kingdom of God, the spiritual realm over which God reigns as king. Do you want him to reign in your life? Then let's follow the principles or the fulfillment on earth of God's will. So that's what we're doing here. We are recognizing that. We are believing, it says in Mark 1:15, to the time of fulfillment, the kingdom is at hand. So repent and believe the gospel. Step number one. Repent, turn around, believe the good news gospel. Remember that. You can't have, you know, this Old Testament laws hanging on to you. Good news gospel, which is far higher and better than what was before the cross, which is far better, based on far better promises. And so he says, all right, guys, you're entering the kingdom. Then let's start looking at how some of these principles work. The kingdom of God is like a man who scatters seed upon the ground. Okay, Pastor, what kind of seed? Well, it says they continue sleeping and rising night and day. When the seed sprouts and grows and increases, he knows not how. So you are the one sowing. Okay, Pastor, what's the big mystery here? What am I sowing? What am I sowing? Well, if we go back a few verses into chapter 4, verse 1 of Mark, it says the sower sows the word. That is what you are sowing. That is what the Holy Spirit through you, through your mouth, is sowing. You're constantly sowing the word. Sow, sow, sow the word. Amen. You're sowing the word. You are the one that is the kingdom of God. I'll read it again. It says the kingdom of God is like a man who scatters seed upon the ground. The kingdom of God is like a Christian, and that Christian is doing. He's got actions going on. He's sowing, sowing, sowing seed upon the ground. Every seed will produce. So will the seeds of destruction, like weeds, like thistles. I've got thistles on my field just from plowing up the field. Think about this principle. I plowed up the field, and the farmer said, there can be dormant seeds in there that are 20 years old, plus 20 years old, and that when you turn over the soil, they become activated. In other words, that soil has become fertile again, and it becomes activated. So guess what? The sower sows the word. You're not the one desiring or sowing the thistles, but maybe from things people have put into you, that seed is being, like the field that I have, is being turned over, and up comes a harvest of things that you don't want in your life. Now, again, it doesn't have to stay there. It is something that you get to deal with and victoriously deal with it. You can overcome that. Whatever the other seed is that's trying to raise its ugly head, that is trying to come up, you are the sower, and you get to put the good seed in the ground. And we're going to believe for crop failure on the bad seed that may be still around. Then continues to sleep night and day while the seed sprouts and grows, increases, he knows not. So is it your responsibility to know how the word works? Really? He's saying, no, it's not. Just do the sowing. Do the principle of sowing the good seed. Sow, sow, sow. How do I sow? I meditate on the word of God day and night. Joshua says, let not this word depart from out of your mouth. What is he saying? Don't fill the seed machine, the one that spreads the seed, with anything else. Do not let the good seed depart out of your mouth, but keep it in your heart. Meditate. We know Proverbs 4 talks about out of the heart comes the issues of life. Okay, we're not going to go there today. I'm just trying to show you the seed is, Joshua said, don't let it leave your heart. Do not replace. You know, that farmer that sowed my seed, he needed to have buy bags of alfalfa seed that he put into my ground. But there's a time where it could run out. He needs to make sure the machine is full. And I did end up with a few bare spots on my field. I don't think it was his fault. It could be. It could be that the machine tilted because it was on a steeper part of the hill, and some of the seed may have gone to one side, therefore maybe just letting air, foddered language, or just air or fluff be coming out of the machine over here. Anyways, whatever it is, maybe it was a human error, whatever, but the seed, like Joshua says, cannot leave your mouth. It cannot leave your mouth. It must be meditated on day and night, day and night, day and night, and it must be released. Deuteronomy chapter 28, this book of the law, you know, it talks about you choosing life in the presence of all the different angels and the demons that are hearing it. And so all we're talking about right now, Pastor, I'll give you a little heads up for next week. You know, what then is something good that I can say out of my mouth? Well, how about through his stripes, I am healed. Now everybody's happy. The Godhead is happy because you're hooking into the principles of God. You're hooking into the kingdom principles of God, which he came to bring you. Nobody else has got this luxury. In fact, the Bible says, to you was given the mysteries of the kingdom. To sow these mysteries, it was given to you. And so for someone to, you know, again, understand the principles, and that's what we're getting to bring to you. No seed sown, no harvest. You don't need to know how the seed works. All you need to do is put it into a believing heart, like a sowing machine, like a field sowing machine, not a zipping sowing machine. It needs to come out of your mouth. What you believe, what you hear, what you are saying, what your spirit man is saying, out of the abundance of the heart, the sowing machine sower. Again, I'm referring to the field that I have sown seed into. Out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So the sower sows the word. The sower sows the word. The sower sows the word. And it, you, again, verse, according to, it doesn't say are an heir if you know how it works. It's just telling you, verse 27, it is so simple. You're going to go to bed and sleep, and the seed is now active in the soil. Now, we haven't covered the soil yet either. There's four different kinds of soil. All of them produce, but only one brings the soil to the end state where it can be harvested. The Bible, for example, in one type of the soil, we haven't covered any of it yet, it says they received it with gladness, but they didn't have enough soil that was turned over. And so guess what happened? It's one of those things where it's just going to come up and die. And we don't want that for your life. This is important. These are the principles that is going to put you over in life. Anyways, that's all the time I have today. If you have any questions, call us at 250-862-3444. We would love to pray with you. You need to make Jesus Christ the Lord of your life if you haven't yet. But that these principles are for all believers, and they will put you over in life. God bless you, and have an amazing rest of the day.